You're watching UNICEF television. UNICEF Deputy Executive Director Geeta Rao Gupta discusses the importance of gender equality in achieving the Millennium Development Goals.
It's important because it provides staff with the how-to. For many years in the field of gender equality, we have focused on the what and the why. What is gender inequality and why is it important? But ultimately, for it to be practiced and integrated within programming, it's the how-to that's the most important. And that's what this guidance provides. It's operational, it's practicable, it sort of demystifies gender equality and how it should be attended to. It advances UNICEF's commitment to addressing gender inequality. It gives concrete examples of how that can be done. It suggests examples of how, what the entry points might be in programming, of how, you know, where questions about gender can be asked by program staff, and how sort of programming can be differently applied for women as compared to men, for boys as compared to girls, and how that context of gender as a social construction of male and female roles can be kept in mind. Gender inequality is a major driver of inequity. It's pervasive, it's persistent, it's very similar across different countries. And we have done a poor job over the past 30 years of global development in addressing it. So the other thing is that it intersects with other forms of inequity. So it intersects with class, with caste, with ethnicity, and becomes a very important variable in the broader definition of inequity to address. So we couldn't possibly fulfill the equity focus and advance the equity agenda without paying attention to gender inequality. I've worked on gender equality and on women's inequality in particular for about 20 odd years now. And repeatedly I have seen that when that piece of inequity is addressed in any context, families, communities, and entire nations can move forward. It is tragic to see actually the ways in which societies allow discrimination based on gender to persist. I'd like to see UNICEF be a leader within the UN in making gender mainstream happen the way it should. And the way it should is that it becomes second nature for staff everywhere to think about gender differences and the possibility of discrimination and how resources and opportunities apply differently to girls as compared to boys or women as compared to men, that should become part of the everyday way in which we work.
You've been watching UNICEF television. For more information, visit unicef.org. Unite for Children.